Okay, please confirm you are seeing my screen.
Yes.
Okay, fine. So very good morning to everybody for organizing such a wonderful webinar series. I am basically a civil engineer with a specialization in coastal engineering. I am from India basically, but I work in Kuwait from 2003. In the area of coastal engineering. So the talk will be certainly useful for all the countries involved in coastal infrastructure development. So I'm going to spend my time on giving a broad information on three different US patents related to coastal infrastructure development. The content of the presentation is like this. We will see first some technical details of some innovative coastal structures. Next, we will little bit focus on the economics of using these type of new developments, also environmental benefits, and we will conclude. Like any other engineering discipline, we need innovation in coastal space development. The reason is not all the country around the world, they have good quality natural resources like stone, for example. In many coastal engineering projects, you need stones, quality stones of different sizes to build port, harbor, marina, coastal protection works. So this is a very highly consumed natural resource for any coastal country. Unfortunately, many countries in the world, they don't have this resource, like Kuwait, for example, Kuwait and the Gulf country here, Kuwait, Qatar, UAE, Bahrain, like that, many countries, we do not have good quality stones. So we need to do innovation to replace stones. We always try to import quality stones from other country. It is very expensive. We pay about $70 for 1 ton of stone by the time it reaches Kuwait. Also, like many countries, it is advisable to use locally available material for different type of construction. Construction industry, whether it is a land-based construction or a coastal ocean-based construction, they always try for how to build infrastructure without much problems and how to make it easy to build. It is always there in the infrastructure companies. All type of constructions also look for the environmental and economic benefits. All company construction company or the user, they always love to have lesser material in the project development, focusing on cost saving. Construction time reduction is another important thing, particularly in ocean structure development. Because in the ocean and coastal area, the strong environment from waves, ocean current and wind, they don't allow the construction 24/7 throughout the year. We cannot do it. So especially coastal project, we can build during fair weather window, which may be a few months in a year. So we have to make our construction innovation shooting short construction period. Last 10-20 years, the world people living on the coastal area, particularly, they wanted to have coastal developments which looks beautiful or aesthetic value. Okay, many countries, they don't want to use stones because they are not aesthetically good looking, no? So they wanted to go for alternative solution. Each and every coastal infrastructure, they are designed for certain function. For example, a breakwater for a port is to reduce the wave inside the port. A offshore breakwater to reduce erosion. Like that, each and every ocean structure have a specific function. So the invention we have to do also, it should help to improve the function of the infrastructure. Like for example, wave energy dissipation or wave energy extraction, like that, the function. So we try to focus on how to improve the function. So with respect to all these things, we will see three different structures. How we developed the science and technology to meet all these expectations. First is innovative floating breakwater. So this is a 3 years of research work. And finally, we could able to go for a US patent. So this I will tell you what it is. A key idea is you have a structure here floating in the sea. The cross section looks like a rectangle with a skirt wall down. The open sea, this is the open sea, always the wave energy is energetic, high wave. Whereas here you have relatively calm condition. You can design this floating breakwater with the mooring arrangements for the design mooring force. You can design them. Design them means what is the width of the structure, what is the depth of immersion, what is the gap you can provide here, what is the force it will receive for that force, what is the mooring anchor you have to design. All these things, they are called complete design, structural design. For a particular wave here, see you don't want waves more than 10 centimeter. For example, a small marina, more than 10 centimeter wave not allowed. Whereas if it is a big harbor for a huge ships, you can allow 30 centimeter. Or this is an area for construction, open sea construction. Depends on the construction facility. You cannot allow waves more than certain height. So based on the application, you need to design this floating breakwater. Our idea, the floating breakwater, this type of a floating breakwater, it will work for only certain conditions. It will not work everywhere around the world. It will work for moderate wave climate. What I mean moderate wave climate is the wave has wave period less than 6 seconds. And the height of the wave less than my height, the normal human height. So if it is a much, much more than our height, this will not work properly. It will not work in cyclone and tsunami, promising cyclone and tsunami area. It will not work. It is difficult to design economically. It particularly, it works and people use in deeper water for different application. Like, for example, you see this, any country with offshore oil and gas or acid, whatever it is, so for loading and unloading of fluids in the offshore deeper water, you have to provide temporary protection, wave protection. So for this situation, the floating breakwater is required. That is only one example I was showing, but then there are many examples we can show. If you see the development, what we have done, many countries, they use pontoon. This is a cross-section, pontoon type breakwater with a moored condition. You need 18 to 20 meter wide breakwater, floating breakwater, to reduce, for example, if wave here is 1 meter, to reduce to 0.5 meter. 50% reduction, you need this type of huge pontoon type of floating breakwater. It is expensive. What we thought, can we take this floating breakwater, cut it into two pieces, say 8 to 10 meter, and then see, you save first 50% of the material. From those material, take some 5 to 10% of the material, attach here as skirt wall, create a compartment. This compartment, during wave action, this structure will respond. This compartment helps to trap energy. So if both of them, the performance, wave damping performance is same, then you can save 40% of the material here. So that will help in economics of wave damping. So that is what the idea at the beginning for us. Then we did a detailed physical modeling study in our laboratory. Finally, we got enough quantity and quality of knowledge for a patent. So what we did is, we took the normal floating breakwater. We started with a single skirt, two skirt, three skirt, five skirt, like that. Because when wave is interacting with this type of structure, the compartment, they try to trap and dampen, create more viscous and vortex induced damping. So that is the basic physics of this. So we did the experimental work for different type of this structure, found out the wave energy transmission character, and also the mooring forces, dynamic response, all those things we did the study. Based on this study, now based on the results, what we can provide to the users or the clients is an optimized, structurally optimized a floating breakwater configuration for their requirement, for their sea condition. For example, the sea condition in Kazakhstan, as we were discussing with Professor few minutes back, sea condition of open Arabian Sea or Bay of Bengal or Pacific. So different type of sea conditions, we can do an optimized design. So that is possible from this invention. The optimized design means, what is the size of the pontoon? What is the depth of the skirt wall? How many number of skirt wall is required? And how much of porosity is required to dissipate energy? Like that. So all these four elements, we could able to provide for our stakeholders. Also, for that particular design, we also provide the mooring force. It is required for field application. And also the dynamic response of the structure, like a heaving, pitching, rolling, all this character for the designed structure we could be able to give. So from that, an optimized design to wave damping is possible. So just to give you an idea how we have presented our result. For example, you see this picture. Basically, in a floating breakwater, the volume of material governs the economics. What I mean is, the width of the main structure governs the design. So I will tell you from here to here, this is what number one means, only one skirt wall at the bottom. This is a two skirt wall, three skirt wall, five skirt walls under the bottom. This is the width of the structure required for different transmission. See, this 0.5 means 50% energy you allow to transmit 0.4 is 40% energy allow, 30% is like that. So imagine you want, you can allow 50% energy, then all these things will work. This triangle, they all will work. What it means, for example, this point means only 8 meter width is required with the 5 skirt walls. If you go for 5 skirt wall like this, you need only 8 meter with 5 skirt wall, the depth of this skirt wall we have. So what you need is 8 meter. On the other hand, if you want to go for 2 skirt wall, what is the width required? This width is, for example, this is the one. You need 10 meter. So here you need 8 meter. With the 3 skirt wall, you need only 9 meter, 10 meter. Whereas a single skirt wall, you need about 20 meter. Or this one without skirt wall, this one, you need about 18 meter width. So all of them are doing same performance. So this is what our innovation. See, this indicates the effect of the porosity in the skirt wall. This is 0% porosity, 10%, 20%, 30%, 40%. Little bit of porosity introduction means a little bit increase in transmission, like, or a little bit increase in width. So that is what it is. The economics, when we talk about economics, for example, we have done a clear calculation of economics for a typical condition for an open sea marina. The open sea marina is something like this. This is a land area. You have a breakwater here, another breakwater. And then you need to provide a wave screen here. This wave screen, and this is used as a marina, 200 meter wide and maybe 150 meter long. So this is the one you have to build. So the boat can come in, stay here, and then go out. So this is a plan view. So this can be either a rubble mound or the new invention, floating breakwater. So what we have done is we have worked out the detailed construction cost for this 200 meter rubble mound breakwater or floating breakwater in a 6 meter contour. So we have done the economics calculation for this. Considering 3 meter tide, moderate wave of 1 meter and wave period of 4 seconds. So this is a parameter we use for economics. In the rubble mound breakwater, so the design is like this. On the seaside, you have 1:2 slope, 1:1.5 slope. So these are all the dimensions for rubble mound breakwater. So we know the quantity of material. Similarly, for floating breakwater, we have worked out the details. So the floating breakwater looks like this. So it is like a box with empty space inside. This is a plan view of the floating breakwater. This is a sectional view with the skirt wall and mooring arrangement. We can make floating breakwater each 12 meter wide. And if it is a 200 meter, you know the number of floating breakwater you need. So the whole floating breakwater can be constructed on a big floating barge or on the land. And then you can lift it and put it on floating barge. And the crane facility in the floating barge can be used to lift and then arrange. So this is the design detail for floating breakwater. We worked out the material requirement for both the structure. Here it is, material requirement for the rubble mound breakwater. You need about 40,000 cubic meter of stone and 10,000 cubic meter of concrete. So totally 50,000 cubic meter of material is required. Whereas for the floating breakwater, you need a total volume of only about 3,000 cubic meter. You can see the difference. So here you need stones and concrete, 50,000 cubic meter. Here you need about 3,000 cubic meter of good quality reinforced concrete. So that is about the volume. So almost if you just see about the percentage of material required, it is only about 6-7% compared to the conventional solution. This is the conventional solution in many places people use. So the new innovation, you need only 6-7% of the material. We took the cost of stones and concrete, everything with reference to local market here in Kuwait. And it may be different in different countries. For example, in India, it may be different. China, it may be different. As I told you, stone cost is high here. This is in Kuwaiti dinar. If you convert into US dollar, it is about 67 US dollar per cubic meter of stone here. Whereas if it is India, it will be about 10 to 15 dollars. Maybe China also, it may be same. Similarly, the cost of concrete here, plain concrete and reinforced concrete. So specifically, we worked out this for Kuwait. So when we do all the calculation for construction, starting from cost of the rubble and the seabed preparation, everything, this is a total cost for this particular 200 meter breakwater. In terms of US dollar, it is about 4 million US dollar. Whereas the same cost for material plus all the other things, mobilization, mooring, scaffolding, transportation, crane charges, engineering study, miscellaneous, all these things, if you include as per the local market, so the cost required is about almost like a 0.6 million US dollar. You can see the cost difference. So finally, we have given a figure, cost of floating breakwater divided by cost of conventional structure. It is, the ratio is about 0.42. So it may be different for country like India. It may be 0.5 to 0.6. Some other country it may be different. So, but still, finally, we can save huge cost for such project. So that is what the economics. When we talk about economics, we have to know also merit and demerit of such project. See, rubble mound breakwater is well-proven technology. Last 250 years, people are using. Whereas floating breakwater technology is developing only last 20, 25 years. So always, the user always have a question whether it is proven for many years. Okay, then rubble mound maintenance will be less because it's a natural material. Maintenance will be less. Wave climate at the harbor side will be much less compared to floating breakwater. Floating breakwater have some advantage. It will allow water to go on both the sides. Water exchange is a good thing for quality of water. And seabed need not be very strong in this case. Whereas here, seabed must be very strong to take the load. So bearing capacity of soil must be strong here. Here it need not be. Even soft clay, you can easily moor properly, and that is not an issue. And the seabed is coral, this will not affect the coral, whereas this will kill the coral completely. And during its lifetime, you can reorient them slightly for optimum wave damping, whereas it is not possible here. When we talk about demerit, as I told you, the water quality behind the breakwater, normally it will become poor. And I told you, seabed, if it is coral, it will destroy the corals. Here, the demerit is maintenance will be a little bit expensive because it is a floating structure. It responds, heaving, pitching, rolling, it responds. So the maintenance will be a little bit more. And there will be some waves always at the rear side. So that we have to keep in mind. Now we will go to innovation two. It is again dissipation of wave energy. The focus is to dissipate wave energy. In the ocean wave mechanics, two things researchers focus. one how to dissipate the energy, another one is how to extract the energy. So this particular topic is how to dissipate the energy. So we did again a project for 3 years and it landed up with a US patent. I will explain the basic principle. This is a typical marina in Kuwait. So like this, you have marina everywhere around the world. If you go inside the marina, you always see stone dumped in a sloped fashion like that. So this much width, something like 10 to 20 meter width of the marina, you cannot use it because the stone occupies this width. And the stone, as I told you, for us it is expensive. So we cannot afford to bring stones always from abroad. So we need to go for alternative solution, which is again cost competitive, easy to build, less environmental impact, you occupy less space here. So that is what the requirement in the innovation. So we did a study. This is our wave flume. You see here, what you see here is a wave is propagating like that. You have vertical walls with the porous plates. Not only one, you have 2, 3, 4 walls like that. See like this. So we did the study for many different combinations of porous wall. 1, 2, 3, like that. Many combinations, many porosities. And finally, we have come up with the following conclusions. See, what you see here is conventional marina or conventional port and harbor with the stones here. So this is based on our new innovation. This width will be almost 3 to 4 times this width. So you are saving huge space inside the marina using the new technology. And this is both of them functionally same, meaning if it is dissipating energy 90%, this also designed to dissipate energy 90%. And volume of material required for this is much, much, much smaller compared to the volume of material here. And again, the whole thing sits on the ground, so benthic life all killed. Here it is not like that. And this space you can design and use it as a mooring for loading and unloading here itself. You cannot do it here. So that way, a lot of merits in this new innovation. So we are advocating this result to the government and to user to build new marina or new harbor, new port using this technology. So this is what we are now commercializing this idea because of so much of merit from economics, environment, ease of construction. So we are strongly advocating the stakeholders to go for using this new technology. So this technology we developed by doing study for a wide range of conditions. First, we did the study with the conventional structure, 6 different conventional structure, rubble mound, armor with the different type of armor. So we did a study, first benchmark study. Then we did a large number of study starting from 1 wall to 6 walls. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because adding each wall means it will dissipate energy better. And with a different porosity, 10% to 60% porosity, like this, 50% porosity. So 37 different structures we used for the study to understand wave damping. And if you see this table, for example, if you see this 10.8% means, in case the solution is 4 wall and 30% porosity, the material requirement is only 11% compared to the conventional solution. That is what. So we have the details of material saving. if we use this technology. And we prepared like a design curve like this. I will just in 1 minute I will explain what this is. Say this x y-axis shows reflection of energy from the structure. If reflection is smaller, it is better, because when wave enters into a harbor or marina, it interacts with the boundary. The boundary extract energy, dissipate energy better, then the mooring operation into the port, harbor, marina is better. So what you see here is the reflection coefficient of conventional structure like vertical wall. Vertical wall structure always reflect full energy. Then a few different sloped structure. So this is the reflection character. And this is what the reflection character of the new type of structure. For example, if you take this number, for example, you take this 24, its reflection is much less, 0.3 is a reflection which is much better than conventional structure. What is 24? That is what I want to show you here. 24 means this. A 5 wall with 30% porosity gives a reflection of only 0.3 compared to, for example, you take number 5. 5 is a rubble mound breakwater with 1:2 slope. So conventional structure. So we prepared this type of information for different wave condition, different wave period condition, which helps for different countries around the world, because wave characters in different countries are different. In Arabian Gulf, it is mild. Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea, it is a strong. If you go to Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, northern and southern side, very strong. So it depends upon the field condition. We prepared this chart. This is the design chart to select appropriate conditions. The merit of this study, the volume of material required is only 10 to 15% compared to rubble mound breakwater. So you save nearly 80-85% volume, and you also get more spacing for berthing. That is next important advantage. More spacing means more revenue for the owner. And as I told you, can be used as berthing structure, like this. See, if you have this, you have more spacing for berthing, and you can use this as a design. You can design, use it as a berthing structure. It is easy to fabricate and assemble. So that is the advantage. Stone means you have to bring them in lorry, keep on dumping. Whereas this new structure, prefabricate, assemble them quickly in the field. And you have the choice of using high strength polymer material from petroleum product. So that way it helps a country like a Gulf country to go for using locally available material, high strength polyethylene, polypropylene material, or fiber reinforced plastics, glass reinforced plastics. So you can use them for construction of this material. So that way import can be reduced. What we can provide to the clients is two things. It depends on if a client A, if he comes with and he says initial budget is not a problem, like rich country, suitable solution can be given. And if a country with financially not rich, if they come, for them also from this study, we should be able to give suitable solution. So both these solutions are possible from this study. What is the meaning of solution? An optimized configuration, meaning number of porous wall and the porosity in the porous wall, which performs better than sloped structure. That is what the aim. So we will provide such type of solution for two type of clients from this study. So that way, clients can save large amount of money in developing new port, harbor, and marina. So that is the application. The same type of application, the economics we did. In the economics, one we calculated using rubble, another one using this structure. So we did the assessment similar to the previous one. And this is how the cross section of the structure looks like. Instead of stone breakwater, the cross section looks like this. In a big port, if somebody wanted to build a big port, the cross section is like this. You have porous wall on both the side, inside the harbor, also outside the harbor. So the design will be like this. And the plan view looks like this, the plan view. You can see slots like this. See, this is one unit. The width of the unit can be designed based on the carrying capacity of crane. So this width can be designed. So all these porous walls prefabricate and easily insert them in the field quickly. So that way, quick construction is possible. So we did the estimate of cost, and finally we came to a number which tells cost of new wave energy dissipator to cost of conventional structure 0.6. That means 40% saving for Kuwaiti condition. For other country, it may be a little bit different when you incorporate mobilization, hiring cost of floating bond, all these things. For the construction of the new dissipator, it may be different for other countries. Also, rubble mound cost may be different. So if it is worked out, it may be different, but definitely it will be much less than conventional solution. Finally, I will give you one more innovation related to the first two, but there is a difference. See here, this innovation we got last year. This is again a wave damper. The wave damper is series of plate, but you allow the wave to transmit. In the previous case, you don't allow wave to transmit. Here we allow the wave to transmit. So that is the only difference here. So what we did is we again did the study with the number of walls, number of porosity. And in the experimental facility, we assess the wave transmission, energy transmission for different input condition. So that is the thing we did in the laboratory. And we compared this study again with a rubble mound breakwater, which is in the air, coming out in the air. So first we did a benchmark study with rubble mound conventional structure, and we did the study for different number of slotted barrier. They are all arranged zigzag like this. So you have a slot here, but here slot is on the upward and downward. We try to make the wave energy pass through a long path. Always, you know, from fluid mechanics, if you allow the fluid to flow a long path, it will dissipate more energy. So we did the study. Then again, here, finally, we come up with a solution for two type of stakeholder. One is country with less issue on the initial cost of construction. Country with less, more, they don't have enough budget. So for both the group, we have the solution here. Again, here optimum configuration means what is the number of porous wall, porosity, which performs better than rubble mound offshore breakwater. That is main aim. It should perform, performance must be better than a conventional structure, but then the volume of material must be much less, and all the other character. Okay, so then this we give, then we give what is the design force and moment and pressure to design the structure. That also we give. All these things we measured in the physical modeling study for thousands of runs, wave runs, different combinations, covering mild, moderate, strong, and very strong wave conditions, covering the oceans and seas and bays. A typical design for Kuwait, there's a similar design can be done for any other condition. In Kuwait, if you have a wave of, for example, 0.9 meter, if you want a transmission of 0.27 or less, what you need is only two walls, 10% porosity, and a bottom slab, which is 0.5 meter thick, to take care of horizontal sliding and overturning. So this is like a ballast working, and this will take care of the wave transmission. So this design we carried out for Kuwait, one condition here in Kuwait. So I'm telling similar workout is possible. And once we done this workout, we know how much material required for such a type of a structure. So to conclude, what I have presented here is on three different type of marine structure. One is floating breakwater. Another one is a structure suitable for new construction of port, harbor, and marina, where you can save a lot of money. For example, a new major port construction means it will be order of many million dollars. Say, for example, $50 million, for example. Using this new knowledge will save 30-40% of the cost for the port harbor construction. And the last one is a wave energy dissipator consisting of series of porous walls. Here also, it can be used for wave damping application in coastal area. Example, if you have an area very seriously eroding, then one of the solution is this new invention. Instead of dumping offshore rubble breakwater, we can use this technology. So they have many positive merits like this. Thank you very much. I hope the subject is useful.
Thank you, Professor. I think this lecture is very, very interesting. You have introduced many new types of marine structures, which are be used to retain the stabilities of the marine stability conditions. Yeah. Now we come to the Q&A section. Any questions?
Good afternoon. Can I ask some questions, please? My name is Asil from Kazakhstan. You designed three types of the structures, and the first one is some floating structure which is breaking the waves. What type of material it made from? Is it concrete? How about the corrosivity? I mean, what kind of anti-corrosion measures were used? And did you consider any recycling plastic, like any other ecological opportunity to use there? And the last question is about this murrays. What is material of the murrays, and what is the designed tension forces it can apply for these murrays? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Asal, for this very interesting question. Many countries, they use floating breakwater with high quality concrete. M50, minimum M50 is required for floating breakwater to reduce the porosity of the structure. Not anything less than M50. And then, you know, nowadays, the steel manufacturers themselves, they supply you steel with protective coating, with suitable polymer protective coating itself. Many steel suppliers, they are supplying. So you should use such type of steel reinforcement, not the normal one we use for land construction. But then if you ask me, I don't prefer to go for concrete floating breakwater. The problem is the mooring line. See, you will attach the mooring line with some spacing. All those points have stress concentration during dynamic response. So designing concrete for stress concentration is also difficult and risky. Chance of local failures are high when it encounters high waves than the design waves. So my personal thing is we should use high strength polymer material like FRP, GRP, fiber, carbon fiber plastics, such type of material we should use for making floating breakwater. That is number my personal point. Then mooring forces can be assessed. From our study, we can get the mooring force for different configurations in terms of Newton itself. We give the mooring force required. Once we know the wave height, period, the structure dimension, its depth of penetration in water, we know the mooring force. So once we know the mooring force, then we can easily design the anchor type of anchor, whether it is a pile type of anchor or gravity anchor, it can be done easily, no problem. So we have the mooring force for different configurations and different conditions.
Okay, thank you very much. And what is the material for this mooring?
Mooring force, again, see, you have a range of material starting from quality nylon. This is what people use for ship mooring for many years. Quality nylon, not the ordinary nylon we use. Quality nylon, Kevlar material, which is very strong. It is like a steel. High polymer material, Kevlar, or we can go for the upper end is stainless steel wire, good quality stainless steel wire is upper range. The lower range starts from nylon, high quality nylon. So this is the range of material we use for mooring.
Okay, thank you very much.
Welcome.
Next question.
So I have some questions also.
Yes, again Professor Askar. Yes.
Questions again from Kazakhstan. Thank you very much, Dr. Dilemani, for your excellent lecture.
Thank you, Professor.
My questions is, I have two questions. You, Kuwait Research Institute belongs to some university or some ministry, or what is this?
This is a government research institute, fully funded by Kuwait government. Yeah, this is a government institute.
So second,
similar to CSIR institute in India.
Thank you.
Second, it is a government research institute, but we work with the universities. We share our facility, knowledge, manpower with Kuwait University. That is also government. So we work together, we share our facility and knowledge together.
And second question, so you demonstrated for us very interesting issues, especially your patent and researching, and also some construction and also some experience, real field some design and field some picture. So who financially support of this very big job?
For the research financing, we have quite foundation for advancement of science, for financing research. That is a major funding agency. Other than some private companies, they come to us with their questions and we try to solve their problems. Also ministry, there are many different ministry, like Ministry of Coastal Development, Public Work Department. So they also sometime come to us and support. And the oil company, they also come to us and fund if the result is useful for them. So the funding is not a big problem here in Kuwait.
Thank you very much. It's very good country, very good country, so much no problem.
Yeah, no, funding for research is not a big issue. If they know the result will be useful in the near future, you get many, many funding agencies.
Thank you very much.
Welcome, Professor.
Professor Nilanmani, I have one question.
Yes, welcome, Professor, welcome.
Yeah, you have gave us a very interesting lecture. From the news, I know that Kuwait is building a very long bridge. Is that right? Yeah.
The bridge in the sea construction is finished. From last 1 year, we are using the bridge.
Oh, I think the longest bridge.
Longest
in
the world. Yes. 45 kilometer long.
Yeah. Can you tell us something related to geotechnical aspects of this project? Yeah.
See, this project, we have in Kuwait a bay called Kuwait Bay. One side, it is open to Arabian Gulf. And see, the bay, you have to go like this. Can I go and give it 1 minute? I will just load a picture and show you.
Yes, great.
Okay, so this is the one. This is the Kuwait Bay. Yeah, can you see the bay, Kuwait Bay?
Yeah, yes.
Right. So this is the main city in Kuwait. And this is a new developing area. They are building a lot of infrastructure here to take care of future population. So we have to go all the way like this to this region. So which is almost like 100 kilometer. If I start from here, I have to travel 100 kilometer to reach this. So they build a bridge connecting this and this like this, they build. So that way they save 60 kilometer travel, they save. So the bridge construction took more than 4 years and it cost about $3 billion. $3 billion. Last 1 year, we are using this bridge.
Have you got a photo of this bridge?
Yeah, the bridge looks like this. So this is the appearance of the bridge in the Kuwait Bay. So this is a total bridge length is 45 kilometer. But we are doing some studies on the environmental impact of this bridge. We are doing a detailed study on that. How the flow pattern changed, how the turbulence, water quality changed because of the construction. We are monitoring and we are working systematically on this aspect.
But this area, especially this area, you haven't maybe, don't have any typhoon or tsunami like Japan.
That is a good, we don't have typhoon, we don't have. Tsunami is expected from Pakistan, all the way from Makran area in Pakistan. If we have a earthquake of 9 in Richter scale, we expect 0.5 meter tsunami. So that is not a big tsunami for us. So that way, tsunami and the cyclone is not an issue. Only issue is the high salinity water, water temperature variation, very large variation of water temperature. In winter, water temperature comes to 11, 12 degrees centigrade. In summer, it goes closer to 37 degrees centigrade. Salinity of the water reaches closer to 45 ppt. So these are all the parameter more important than waves, tsunami, and cyclones.
Yes.
We have current velocity of closer to 1 meter per second for 5% in a year. So the design is mainly for 1 meter current, 1 meter per second current, and waves of about 1.5 meter. So that is the way we did the design. On the top of the bridge, you can see the top, it is like this.
The depth of this water is not the depth of water.
Depth of water goes up to 20 meter.
Not so,
it
not
starts
so deep.
With not so, zero.
Not so deep. Only, 20 meter, not so deep.
No, only 20 meter maximum. Maximum 20 meter. It starts with zero. It goes like this 20 meter, then again it raises to zero. Mm-hmm. Only one single curve like this. So 20 meter water you get somewhere at the middle of this bay. So this is a Kuwait City. So while traveling on the bridge, you can see clearly the Kuwait City. Yeah, far view a little bit far away from the water, you can see this. So this is the main area for allowing for navigation. So this is the water from the water level to the bridge here is almost like 14 meter. This area, when you go here, then it comes down to 4-5 meter. So here navigation we allow. So this is the area for navigation. You can see the slope is increasing steadily here. So on the route, we have two places we have island on the route. So people can stay and they can refresh and again they can start.
Here in China, we have a similar project. the Hong Kong to Macau bridge.
That's also a very tough
project.
Because China, you experience very strong waves and very strong winds of 200 kilometers per hour you face. But our here, the design wind speed is about 70 to 80 kilometers per hour. It is not like East Coast of India. Most of the structure is designed for 200 kilometers per hour. In China also, you design for high wind speed. But here, we design for 80 to 100 kilometers per hour.
Okay, thanks for your introduction.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you. Welcome. Most welcome.
So I think now we come to the end of this webinar. Thank you, Professor Nalamani, for your interesting presentation. Thank you all the participants in this webinar. Then now it comes to the end of this session. Bye-bye. See you next time.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah. Bye. Best wishes to all the participants.
Thank you. See you.
See you.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you.
Bye. In Kuwait.
Bye.
In Kuwait.
See you next time, Professor Askar.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah. Take care, Professor Askar. Thank you very much. Dr. Asal for the nice question. Thank you very much.
Yes. Bye.
Thank you too. Bye.
Thank you.